here with a DIY that's going to bring back all of that back to school nostalgia for everyone at home is Maria. Welcome, Maria. We're so excited to have you. I was going to say, before we even start with your really adorable DIY, can we talk about how beautiful our new craft is?
Take it all in. Just take it all in.
And Maria gets to christen it for the first time. Congratulations.
Really amazing.
It's a crafter's dream come true. Like the organization, look at how beautiful everything is. A wrapping paper and it's color coded.
Can I just say this too? Maria was hanging out in here all day. When the cameras weren't here. She was just hanging out.
I loved this house before, but now I'm really moving in.
And I love the inspiration and the hot glue
everything.
Is hot. That's true.
You found that out the hard way.
Yeah.
These are all true statements.
Oh, this is my favorite. You used my fabric scissors to cut what?
And then you're not friends with that person anymore.
What every crafter in this home has said to me.
I was there. I witnessed those words come out of somebody's mouth. Yeah. All right.
Oh, no.
Well, we know that Grant, of course, is heading into transitional kindergarten. That's a very big deal. Yeah. And we also happen to know that he's pretty psyched about his homework station, right?
Yes. So he's going to TK. I mean, the TK is what they're calling transitional kindergarten now.
Okay,
you can
TK,
see Grant
TK.
There. He is so excited. So the
I can't
first,
tell. How do you know he's excited?
Going back to school, exactly. That's why this room gives me so much inspiration because it's so organized that I want to get organized at home. And I learned at parent night from his teacher that they're going to obviously be having homework, starting to get homework.
It's
fun homework, but it's more getting them excited. So she recommended creating a place in your home that is specific for homework. And I wanted Grant to be excited about it, so I created a giant pencil where he can organize all of his stuff.
Which is really cute. It's a very clever idea. And it looks like we probably have most of these things lying around at home anyway.
Yes, these are really simple supplies that you can get at any craft supply store. So over here we have some scrapbook paper. I mean, I lose hours in scrapbook paper because there's so many great options. And this is just some foam sheets. I have a wood round, some scissors, an X-Acto knife, a pencil for our pencil, and some paint brushes, and foam core, which we all know and love because Ken was using it earlier, of course, and it's a really great thing to craft with. And this is the base of our pencil, is the foam core.
And you got to cut out that sort of pencil shape, but I know that you prefer to score it a few times before you make the final cut.
You are already a pro at this. Yes, so that is the best tip in terms of the foam core and using an X-Acto knife. The second thing is use an X-Acto knife with a fresh blade. You want it to be extremely sharp, otherwise it's going to start pulling. So
it'll fray?
Yes, exactly.
Okay. So my four-year blade is not going to cut?
Not so much. And so as you can see, I'm scoring, so I make my mark first, and this is after you measure everything out. You can see with the sharp X-Acto knife, it'll do that perfectly.
Yeah, that's
and it's
beautiful.
Nice and smooth because you are going to see the edges, exactly.
Right.
So if you don't have a new blade, it's going to just be jagged and not look nice because you're seeing it at the edges. So I created the size of this because of the base, like I said, is a wood round.
Okay.
So this is a 5-inch wood round right here. And so this wood round, you can see, like here, 5 inches. So this is 5 inches. All of the measurements are going to be on HallmarkChannel.com if you want to create this exact size. In terms of height, I just kind of played around a little bit, but that was really how I figured out the size of this. And to create the slit so that it goes together, this is the thickness of this because they're going in. So it's about 1/4 inch.
Okay.
So I'll show you what I mean by that. You can see I have my slits here that I cut. So this one I'd already cut.
All right.
So what you do is they go in like this.
Yeah, it makes sense right here.
And
it becomes a pencil.
And it's a pencil.
But then you put a tip on it.
Exactly. So you don't have to worry about this being too perfect at the top because we are going to cover it.
Okay.
But yeah, so that, and then you paint it, of course.
Okay.
So I know, and my tip in order to make it look like a pencil is that what you want to do is actually when it's together, take your pencil to, you know, make your pencil. What you want to do right here is to create your lines here.
The lead.
Just like so. This is for your lead. And so what I do here, you can see, I'm going to turn it up so you can see. And
curve.
Let me show you.
Yeah.
So that when it's down here, and these would all be done. All your things would be done.
Do you do it before you put them together or after?
So you make your marks. Here, let me show you.
You put it together and then do it that
way. So you do this. Yeah. So you would do all of these here.
So they all match up.
Right. Smart.
So that when you
have a guide.
Yes.
Okay.
You have these here, and this is what I mean. So when you take this and you do your paint.
Yeah.
You go like this.
Interesting, because otherwise they're not going to match up when you put
them together. Exactly. And to be honest with you, so you can see there's our like part of the top pencil. Okay. Yes, to be honest with you, once it's together, you can always do some adjustments, but that is what I have here. Afterwards, you do the pillow.
Yeah, and the little curve sells it. I love that.
Exactly.
Now, you touched on this a little bit already, but I love, so you use the wood round, the wood round as the base, and that helps to sort of stabilize the whole thing. Obviously,
exactly.
You're going to be pulling pencils in and out of this.
Yes.
Kids involved.
You want it to be stable. So I had actually practiced this with foam core as the base, and it didn't work out that great. So what I have here is my base here, and all you do is use your glue gun
to cover it.
Do you need an extra set of hands? No, you got this.
You know what? You can hold this.
Okay, there we go.
Hot glue is hot. Just, don't forget what's written on the wall.
It says so right there.
Yeah, it does.
And if you want to hold it on the back, I'll do a little bit
here. And I love
how
you can get creative with your color scheme.
Exactly. So what you can see over with our pencils over here.
Ooh, hot glue's hot.
Oh, Deb.
We just proved it.
Boy.
We just proved it right here, right now.
No, there goes my skin.
Oh, no. This is the second time Debbie has burned herself on hot glue in my segment.
Well, this is the first injury of the season. It's good luck.
The first casualty.
Like yeah. All right, so then you get creative with the color
scheme. And then you do your creative color scheme. So, that's what I think we said. Over here, you can see, Cameron, can I have you hold this?
Yeah, you got it.
I have the pencils and the traditional number two pencil.
Are you asking me to hold it because you're worried about Debbie?
Yes,
probably. She knows better than to ask me to do it again.
And so you could do, I have a blue and I have a red. Yeah, and so you could do the colored pencils. Any way you like, because I did a traditional one, the colored pencil. You could do any color, but because kids love primary colors at the age Grant's at.
I like it. And these are all the nice finishing touches, obviously. The base that you're making the pencil, the tip of the pencil.
Exactly. And that'll dry.
You've also got the cool Lazy Susan style, like roundabout there, which I like, which is a little bonus. Let's just see that real quick.
That is
right
so
there,
cute.
And all that is a Lazy Susan, just so I can show you guys, quickly that this is the base, 6-inch Lazy Susan that goes on the bottom glue.
And that's as easy as it is.
You do this and flip,
and then you can spin it.
And I love that you've used
spin it and
use paper.
It looks like paper. You do white paint and a couple of permanent markers, and
that's
your paper right there.
Well done, Maria.
That's good stuff.
Grant's gonna love
this. I'm sorry, you got burnt.
That's okay. Part of the job, hazards of the job. For full instructions, you all be sure to visit HallmarkChannel.com, and you can also visit Maria on her website.